Hello everyone, welcome you all in this video tutorial. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the enzyme restriction endonuclease. So let's start with some basic facts about enzymes. So basically most of the enzymes are protein in nature, but there are some exceptions like ribozyme, which is ribosomal RNA or rRNA and help to catalyze the biological reactions. So, enzymes can be defined as biological substances that catalyze the biochemical reactions that are polymer of amino acids and act as a catalyst for biochemical reactions in living organisms. Now, in this video, we are going to discuss about a specific type of enzyme named as restriction enzyme or restriction endonuclease. So basically, it is a type of enzyme which have specialty to cleave a DNA molecule, that's why commonly known as molecular scissor. Also, now here the name restriction is given due to their tendency. Actually, these enzymes are naturally produced in bacterial cells, and in bacteria, they help it to protect or restrict from foreign DNA molecule or pathogens like bacteriophages or many other viruses. So basically what it do, it cleaves the foreign DNA into pieces, and thus it is called a restriction enzyme. And these enzymes cleave the phosphodiester bond of DNA, that's why they are called endonuclease. Here the word endo means inside and nuclease means nucleic acids. So the enzyme cleaves the nucleic acid or the DNA molecule from inside or in between the phosphodiester bonds of the DNA. Now these enzymes have a specialty that they are very specific for their recognition sites, and they used as an important genetic tool in molecular biology. So let's discuss some characteristic features of endonuclease. So, the existence of these enzymes were first postulated by W. Arbour. Later in 1970, Hamilton Smith and his co-workers isolated the first restriction enzyme from bacterium Haemophilus influenza. Now, as we have discussed earlier, that restriction endonuclease are very specific, which means that they can only cleave at a particular site of DNA molecule for which they are coded. For example, a type of endonuclease cleaves at a site GAATC, and these alphabetical characters indicate the nitrogenous basis of DNA. Then it will only cleave the DNA where this sequence will be present. And sequences recognized by endonucleases will palindromic base pairs. Now let's understand the nomenclature of restriction enzymes. So there are several rules for naming of these enzymes. Basically the name of any restriction endonuclease consists of three parts, which are: the first one is an abbreviation of genus and species from which bacterium the endonuclease was isolated. And the second was a letter or a number which indicates the strain of particular species. And the last word indicates a Roman number or a Roman numeral, which indicates the order of identification of this endonuclease in the particular bacterium. So let's understand with an example. Now the name of common endonuclease E. coli is named as follows. Here we can see the name of E. coli restriction enzymes was derived as E, C, O, R and 1, which is a Roman numeral. So here the alphabetical word E indicates the Escherichia, which is the name of genus of bacterium from which the restriction enzyme was isolated. And the next word CO is denote to the or indicate to the species of E. coli. And the third word consists of R, which is the strain RY13 of the E. coli bacterium. And one is the order of identification in the bacterium. So now, based on the composition and enzyme cofactors required for their activity, the restriction enzymes or restriction endonucleases are categorized into four groups, which are type 1, type 2, type 3 and type 4 enzymes. So here, this is the comparison chart describing the comparison between type 1, type 2 and type 3 restriction enzymes. In this comparison chart, we can see the differences between both the three types of restriction enzymes. Here we can see that type 1 enzyme are bifunctional and they have both restriction as well as methylase activities. But in the case of type 2 enzyme, it are unifunctional and have only restriction ability. But in the case of type 3 endonuclease, they are also bifunctional and have restriction and methylase activities. Now the type 1 endonuclease have 3 subunits, the type 2 endonuclease have 2 identical subunits, and in the case of type 3 endonuclease, they have 2 subunits which are different. The type 1 enzyme requires ATP and magnesium ion as the cofactors for its activity, and in the type 2 endonuclease requires only magnesium ion for its activity, and in the case of type 3, it also requires ATP and magnesium ion for its activity. So here are some examples also for type 1 and type 2 and type 3 endonucleases respectively. Now the type 4 enzymes can only cleave the methylated DNA and have very weak sequence specificity. Now let's understand the working of restriction endonucleases with this diagram. So in this diagram, we can see the segment of DNA molecule or the segment of double-stranded DNA. Here we can see the two strands or complementary strands of DNA having nitrogenous bases. And here we can see these nitrogenous bases are palindromes of each other. So when we apply the particular restriction endonuclease which can cleave this particular sequence, it will cleave the phosphodiester bond between A and T, means adenine and thymine, and here the guanine and cytosine will be methylated and thus protect themselves from cleaving. Now after the cleavage, these both are perform as a sticky ends, and they will now after joined with DNA ligase enzymes and used recombinant DNA technology or many other molecular biology techniques. Now this is the another diagram which is showing a plasmid having different sites for different restriction enzymes. Here we can see different names of restriction endonucleases which are E. coli, Hindi 3 and many others, and the arrows are indicating the sites which will cleave by these restriction endonucleases. So now let's discuss about the application of restriction endonucleases or restriction enzymes. So the first or the most important application is in gene cloning. The restriction endonuclease cut the plasmid and produce single strand chains. Then two DNA molecules are ligated with the help of enzyme DNA ligase to form single double-stranded DNA molecule. And there are many other uses of restriction endonucleases in the field of recombinant DNA technology. It is also used to cleave and join with the help of DNA ligase and to make the required DNA molecule. And there are many other fields or other processes of molecular biology where the restriction enzymes are used. So in this video, we have discussed about the discovery of endonucleases, their working, their nomenclature and their applications in the field of molecular biology. I hope you all have now understand the enzymes restriction endonucleases properly. Thank you.